boy, I wonder what wacky adventures Sean and Gus are up to since Psych ended. Captain Cinema. Well, anyone who's ever watched Psych knows that James Roddy, who played Sean, directed some of the best episodes, even paying homage to Alfred Hitchcock, and he did a damn good job at it. So, how would he fare with a full-length movie? Gravy is the story of Anson, played by character actor Michael Weston.
My name is Michael Weston.
Not that Michael Weston, this Michael Weston. Although that would have been awesome. Imagine if Michael Cera were even more awkward.
Who the fuck is Kevin Bacon?
What? Hello? I am laughing at you because that is so dumb. Kevin Bacon? Kevin Bacon is the center of the movie universe, and I don't want to hear any of this bullshit about Brian Cox, because it's Kevin Bacon, and it's always been Kevin Bacon, and it always will be. And maybe you'd know that if you had an ounce of culture or any interest in the arts. Eat a hot bowl of dicks, Mimi.
Our lead, ladies and gentlemen, who's excited because of his Halloween tradition.
Every eve of every Halloween.
At a Mexican restaurant cleverly named Raul's. We meet the rest of the cast. Carrie, the bartender. Cricket, the flirty waitress, played by the middle sister from the show Last Man Standing.
Sad to say, I'll never take you back, so wave goodbye to my Pyrex.
Yannick, the cook. Hector, the aspiring fighter. Precious.
I don't play these games. This is some sick white people only sh.
And comedian Paul Rodriguez. Is this your punishment for the movie A Million to One? The staff is getting ready to throw a surprise going away party for Carrie.
Oh, you guys! I can't believe this!
So, they're oblivious to the couple making out in the corner booth, and the guy drinking himself silly because his proposal was rejected. When the doors are locked, the staff starts to become concerned. Because they didn't lock him. Anson reveals himself as the culprit with the help of the couple who turn out to be Steph, Anson's brother, played by another character actor, Jimmy Simpson, and his girlfriend, Mimi.
This is turning into a snooze fest. We've killed, like two people.
Inform the captives of their tradition, which is to play games with everyone first. Then they inform their captives that they're to be eaten one by one.
Here's the skinny. We have got a variety of wacky activities on the docket for tonight.
Meow.
The stage has clearly been set for an old-school, pseudo-European, gangster-style slumber party.
Why pseudo?
Seriously, like we're not good enough for the real thing?
We're gonna eat you guys.
See, I told you that Raul joke was a clever one. It's clear from the fighting that Mimi and Anson don't get along.
You know what, Mimi? You're a cat, okay? You're a freaking black cat. Don't judge me.
Yet Anson is smitten with Carrie, but Carrie is smarter than the captors. Will anyone survive? Will the cannibals get their feast? Will you ever be able to stop humming the 80 songs throughout this movie? Damn you, Tears for Fears, for being so catchy! It's filmed well. It's gory without relying on being too gory, including a running joke where Cricket keeps getting sprayed with blood. The plot moves along at a decent pace, and the humor is funny. Including a cameo by the director and Dulé Hill. You can tell it was shot on a limited budget, but it uses the limited sets to their advantage and creates suspense. The cast works well off of one another and gives decent performances. Paul Rodriguez gives a decent, albeit short, performance.
We know that you will be fulfilling your dream of helping those in need. That's hardly a surprise from all of us who are lucky enough to call you friend.
And Jimmy Simpson is actually kind of scary in an intellectual superior kind of way. The strange choice of music works in the movie's favor. And a bittersweet ending that I don't know if I should love or hate this movie. It's one of the better cannibal movies I've seen. Definitely better than Green Inferno. If you find it, check it out because it's worth a watch. That's just my opinion.
I know, you know, that I'm not telling the truth. I know, you know.